What do YouTube? B. Kelly, back again with another banger. In today's video, I'm going to explain why Andrew Wiggins is not a bust. Andrew Wiggins was the number one selection in the 2014 NBA draft by the Cleveland Cavaliers, but he would eventually be traded to the Minnesota Timberwolves in the Kevin Love deal. Coming out of high school, Andrew Wiggins was the number one player in the nation in the 2013 class, and he would eventually choose to go to Kansas to enhance his basketball career. At Kansas, Wiggins played very, very good, like the number one player in the nation would. He played 35 games, averaging 17 points, 6 rebounds, and 2 assists, shooting 45% from the field and 34% from the three, and shooting 78% from the free throw line. After having a great freshman season at Kansas, Andrew Wiggins would declare for the 2014 NBA draft. After an amazing freshman season at Kansas, NBA scouts and just scouts in general were comparing Andrew Wiggins to LeBron James and Vince Carter. If you didn't take Andrew Wiggins with the number one pick, you would look like an idiot at the time. But Andrew Wiggins does have his weaknesses that people noticed while he was playing college ball. People have pointed out that he lacks a motor in him, and he's very inconsistent with trying his best at all times, and he lacks defense awareness. In his rookie season, he averaged 17 points a game, shooting 44% from the field and 31% from the three, along with 5 rebounds and 2 assists. He also won Rookie of the Year award that season as well. But the Timberwolves in his rookie season did not have much success, as they went 16-66, but they would land the number one pick and get Karl Anthony Towns. In Andrew Wiggins' second season in the NBA, he did very well, averaging 21 points a game, shooting 46% from the field and 30% from the three, along with 4 rebounds a game and 2 assists. The Timberwolves saw more success this season, winning 29 games and only losing 53, but they would miss the playoffs yet again. In his third season, he saw even more success, averaging 24 points a game, shooting 45% from the field and 36% from the three, along with 4 rebounds and 2 assists. In this season, the Timberwolves went 31-51, and it really seemed like they just needed one player to help them get into the playoffs. One all-star player. So it happened. The Timberwolves that offseason traded Zach LaVine, Chris Dunn, and the number 7 pick, which would eventually become Lauri Markkanen, for Jimmy Butler. As expected in his fourth season, some people thought he wasn't going to score as much as he had in the past due to Jimmy Butler coming into the system. But he still did pretty well, averaging 18 points a game, shooting 44% from the field and 33% from the three, along with 4 rebounds and 2 assists. Also, in this season, the Timberwolves went 47-35, making the playoffs, being the 8th seed in the Western Conference. But they never made it past the first round. But in this offseason, all hell would break loose for the Timberwolves, as Jimmy Butler would call out multiple young players of the Timberwolves, such as Andrew Wiggins and Karl Anthony Towns. And Jimmy Butler even claimed Andrew Wiggins has no heart and he does not care about the game. Now, since all this madness happened this offseason with Jimmy Butler and the young players of the team like Andrew Wiggins and Karl Anthony Towns, it was very unclear how the team was going to perform, since team chemistry seemed like it was very bad at the time. Andrew Wiggins did not play that well this season, even though he kind of did, it's just his shooting went down a lot. He did average 18 points a game, which is pretty impressive, but he only shot 41% from the field and 34% from the three, along with 5 rebounds and 3 assists. Also in this season, the Timberwolves missed the playoffs yet again, going 36-46, and yes, they did trade Jimmy Butler, as he was extremely mad about being on the team. And now, Minnesota Timberwolves fans are out for Andrew Wiggins. They no longer want him on the team. They think his contract is terrible, and now we have people making claims that Andrew Wiggins is the biggest disappointment slash bust from the 2014 NBA draft class, all because of the Jimmy Butler incident and how he played this past season. He is now in multiple trade talks about getting traded from the Timberwolves, possibly to go to another team. Now, I do not agree with any of these statements anyone is making or any videos people are making about him, because I think Andrew Wiggins has been playing great his whole career. Yes, he's had a couple off years when they had Jimmy Butler. Him and Jimmy Butler did not mesh well. I think he is still one of the best players out of the 2014 NBA draft class, and he still has a lot of time left. He's only 24 years old. A lot of people forget that. Yes, he may have been drafted in 2014, but he's only 24 and still has a lot of potential left. I think he can do very big things still with his career, but something that I think kind of threw people off is you compared him to LeBron James. LeBron James is easily the second best basketball player in basketball history, behind Michael Jordan, of course. Making such a claim would just be unfair for anybody. Like, he could be averaging 25 a game and be shooting terrible. People be like, oh, he still sucks. But I disagree with all these statements. I think he is still a very good player. And yes, he will probably be traded this upcoming season. But I know any team he goes to, he's going to do great next season.